Well, that is now the current chairman of the Kenya Rugby Union, Oduor Gangla, speaking to Maxwell Wasike on what he intends to do for the Kenya Rugby Union. Now, joining us here in studio right now is one of the elected directors for the Kenya Rugby Union, our friend here on Touchline, and usually comes to analyze some of the big news in the rugby world. That is Mwalimu Kikechi Kombo, who is here to talk to us about everything Kenya Rugby Union. The big question now, the election is done, and the big question is, what is next for Kenya Rugby Union? Karibu sana Mwalimu,
yes.
And that's where we start with you.
Yeah, thank you for asking.
Congratulations.
Okay, nashukuru. Thank you so much.
Yeah. The big question is, what's next for Kenya Rugby Union, considering now that the election is done, everything is done, now it's back to business, and you have a mandate as a board and as everyone else at the Kenya Rugby Union, plus all the stakeholders, to do something for the Kenya Rugby fraternity. So what is next for Kenya Rugby Union?
There's quite a number of things. Like, now the league is ongoing, they have to continue and finish the fixtures. Then from there, we're also having test matches coming up, Kenya, the Gold Cup, and also we find that in the next 2 weeks we'll be hosting CAR Under 20. So Kenya, the board will be setting up the teams at the Kenya Rugby Union. I find they do the booking and also have the conducive environment for the tournament to kick off.
Yeah.
You find that this is an African tournament. You find that the whole world will be focusing to see these are the future guys who will be playing for the national. These are the guys who will be putting the African rugby on the world map in future. So we'll be able to see how we'll be able to perform. Shall our team also be able to do well?
Yes.
The guys who've grown through the development, they are being given a chance.
Mm-hmm.
So that will be able to show us where are we in the African rugby at the end of the tournament.
Some of the major problems, that most of the current problems that the Kenya Rugby Union was going through, was player welfare.
Yeah.
And from what we have heard from the chairman now, Mr. Oduor Gangla, is all about getting the player welfare back on track, and some of the senior players who had boycotted their training are now back into the team. What is the feeling like from some of the reliable sources at the Kenya Rugby Union? Are these players now back, and are they training for most of the Asia Tour, which will be going to Hong Kong and Singapore?
It's good news for the Kenyan rugby. The players are back and know they have realized now it's time to play, and who will never want to play next year? We can't be out for some time, and find that if Kenya gets relegated and opportunities come up next year, so it'll be also be blaming themselves, saying, oh, I think we could have played. But it's good that the management and the Kenya Rugby Union official talk to the players and they are back, but still the talk is ongoing.
Yes.
And we are happy that they are already in the camp. Even today in the morning they were in training, and the coaches and the team managers are happy. So we focused in to do well, despite being in a very tough pool in Hong Kong. But we hope we'll be able to do well. The first six legs has been not good, but you see now it's also good to give the young players opportunity to play, and that also indicates that the Kenyan rugby, actually we are doing the right thing.
Yeah.
Because the guys who were given opportunity when the senior players were not there, they were playing good rugby. And so probably if we integrate now with experienced players in the remaining legs, Kenya will be safe when we'll be out from relegation. And I know it will be very hard for Kenya to be relegated, as we've been watching the other teams like Wales, Japan playing so far. But you see now we didn't have the experienced players coming up. So if now they are there, definitely we'll be out of relegation, and that will be good for next year to maintain our status at the IRB series.
Yeah, actually one of the major things that came out when the senior players boycotted the training and not playing for the Kenya rugby was that gap between the experienced players and the players who are now joining the team Shujaa coming up. As someone now who will be one of the people making major decisions, considering how development will be going on, how will you be dealing with this in a sneak preview, more so in development rugby, so that we don't get that big gap between the experienced players and the younger players who are joining the senior team?
Yeah. Oh, okay. Well, I've been in development, the way you've said, with the comrades, age grade rugby. We are from under 10, under 14, under 15. That's a very vibrant project.
Yeah.
And we've seen now, put the first batches are already now graduating to senior, to club Kenya Cup teams.
Yes.
You've seen like Kevin Agwamba now playing for Homeboys RFC, Amon Wamalwa, whatever. It's the guys who've grown from age grade rugby, winning East Africa, and coming back and now playing for number 10 at Homeboys. We also have others in Daniel Okito, halfback center at Nondis, Makumi now captaining the Strathmore RFC. These are guys who've come through age grade. Paul Musami at Impala, playing center today. I've seen him being given that position. So these are players who've grown the age grade rugby. They have a lot of skills in terms of playing. So the best thing is we will get. It's good to get players get involved in many tournaments and also given an opportunity. For example, if the CAR tournament is there, we give a youthful team to go and represent the country. So from there, they'll be able to get that experience. Whenever a call up comes up that they are supposed to represent the country, you find that they are ready because they already have that exposure and they will not be having that stage fright in terms of when they are playing in big stadiums across the world. Yeah.
And then, as we're still speaking, and you heard there the chairman saying that right now, when you're going to the corporate, it's not about visibility alone. It's all about giving them a chance to show them that this is what they can do. And some of the companies out there are more so into youth empowerment. Yeah. And when you look at our link between high school rugby and university and college rugby, going on to the professional rugby, how is that link so far?
Well, the gap is not that big because there's that youth progressive. But you see now that we need to have something, a smooth transition from one level to another.
Yes.
Like high school rugby, we need to have more franchise tournament other than just having schools holding to their own school team to going all the way to East Africa. I think a certain level whereby we are done with the county games,
yes,
we give the selectors an opportunity to pick the best teams and then the best players, then team up and then they go and represent that particular county at the region. I think that one does something good. Like at times we played, Comrades played Academy under 14,
yes,
played South African team at KRU, that was sometime 2014. And finally these players met at the airport and
yes,
within one day they already had gelled and they were playing because of what they are used with the playing of the franchise tournaments.
Yes.
So so far it's like people are holding so much on their own. Mm-hmm. But if we can be able to go and integrate now and bring in the issue of the franchise, I think that would be something good for the Kenyan rugby.
Talking about franchise rugby, one of the major countries that have managed to put franchise rugby on the map has to be South Africa.
Yeah, sure.
You see what they do with their Orange, what they do with their companies. They have a very serious franchise rugby down there. How can we do it? Because here in Kenya, we've got all our tournaments.
Yeah.
We've got the Stanbic series, the circuit that usually goes on. We've got the Kenya Cup matches that are going on today, I think match day 14 right now.
Yeah, sure.
But how can we get to franchise rugby?
Just simply putting up the structure, then we involve the stakeholders. Once the stakeholders have been involved and we come up with a fixture,
yes,
for the franchise to be played, then we adjust the fixture, the national fixture,
yeah,
so that at the end of the day we know now from this particular tournament we are done with this, so we move on the franchise. If it's given us a period of,
yes,
its own, then it will be able to pick up very well,
yeah,
so that people, teams, team managers can be able to prepare for that. Then we have selectors also who will be able to bring them together. I think that will be work upon. It also be on the national fixture.
Yeah.
Yeah. Then probably the corporate also coming up, yeah, to sponsor, because that's the biggest problem.
Yeah.
Once we don't have the sponsor for that, then it becomes something difficult to work on.
Corporates, for them, they are there. It's just showing them that how good are you and how can we help you out. It's usually a matter of what can you give me and what can I give you back.
Yeah.
And Kenya Rugby Union has been getting a fair share of their corporates, but at the moment they usually suffer. But you've got some of the best corporates, like the Circuit Corporate is back and it's doing very well.
Yeah, yeah.
And Kenya Cup now, you've got a TV sponsor.
Yeah, sure.
And rugby is being visible in the country.
Yeah.
But now let's talk about high school rugby, because that's your expertise, that's your area of expertise.
Yeah.
What is your secret, more so with your high school, Mwiri Mushi?
Yeah, I find it you just have a program, and once you have a workable program for the players, you definitely be able to pick up. And being working with a boarding school, it's far much better than working with a day school, where sometimes players go home, they find some problems on the way, probably they miss school. So you find that if a player doesn't be in school, you find that you can't be able to carry out your training properly. But the best thing is for you to have a training program with your players. You find that you give them the training schedule and they'll be there on time. There's probably a day for just conditioning, there's a day for ball work, there's a program, a day for attack, for defense, working on the kicks and all that, so that each player knows which area is working on and improving, and you keep on observing them. That's what has been. So long as you tell them and give them a program, you will always succeed. But once you don't have a good program for the team, then they won't be able to do well. So I have succeeded going all the way to win East Africa with Muhuri Mushiri. Just a non-school, not playing rugby, but you find that they are playing rugby well.
Powerhouse.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. Qualified for nationals in Mombasa, and they'll be playing from 7 to 14th in Mombasa.
Yeah.
And probably we hope they'll do well and again qualify for East Africa in Mwanza in August.
That's a big one for you. But there were some major developments from the Kenya secondary schools that came around here, where they were cutting off the numbers of the players that were going to play. I think in the under 15 they were getting now players to, I think, 17.
20 instead of 23. Yeah, sure.
Yeah, and also in the sevens, they were cutting you to
11 players
instead of 15.
Yeah, sure.
How is that one going to affect you guys when you are preparing for all these tournaments that you are going for?
Well, it will be able to affect, and this the problem is that probably the people who are making the decision, they are not well versed with the game itself, because what does the World Rugby rule say about the players? They have done the experience from year to one year to another, and come up to say that the number of players for 15, they are supposed to be 23. But you see now, they are talking, of course, the merging of the games. These are different games, and they are denying opportunity for players to play, and they are putting the same tournament at the same time. Initially it was okay, 15 was first term, second term was seven. But see now the matches, the game is 7 and 15 play concurrently. So you find that 1 week a tournament is played, then the whole year there's no rugby in high school. That's something very bad, whereby they could have just talked with the experts and then gone down, be told about the World Rugby rule. What does the World Rugby rule say about the sevens format?
Yes.
He's supposed to be 12 players, but see now, like now they have added one non-traveling player to assist, because they know anything can happen. The magnitude of the game is changing, and it's more of scientific, and they need number of players. In World Cup, you see the teams will travel, over 30 players traveling for World Cup in Japan coming up in this year.
Yes.
So it's not informed. It's going to affect the game. And I find that this one's going to create fatigue to some of the players. 11 players. So for example, if you get two players get injured, they're out of the tournament, or three. So you have 8 players and you're playing sevens.
Yeah.
So what happens now? No, what happens if probably the first players who got into injured, the forward players, front row, and local subs, they who carry the front, because they are more prone to injuries. So that may definitely, that team will be out of competition if you have the three forward players got injured.
Yeah.
So that's where the problem is, and it's not good for the game. And it's something now that the rugby union, we are now supposed to take the audience of the ministry. Of education, we talk to him, then we explain to him about the changes, not good for the sport, so that we go back, they give the three number of players to travel to the tournament, and also seven be given the 12 players to travel. Yeah.
That will be a major conversation for another day, because now we are talking about the curriculum, we are also talking about academics and how to fuse these things together and make them work. We've got big tournaments coming, we've got test matches, the Gold Cup is also underway, and we have the CAR under 20 for our team.
Yeah.
In all this tournament, how do you see the progress of Kenya Rugby Union right now? Because now we'll be put up with many tournaments and we are supposed to perform.
Yeah.
Are our players ready, more so the young players? Because now they have been put into the major experience. They think the series circuit is the best experience you can be thrown into player.
Yeah. I think when you look at the progress of the Kenyan rugby, it's beyond the rise. When you look at the 15th team qualifying for repechage for the first time in history, that was a very big achievement. Initially, we had never done that, and found that this time round, the Kenyan team managed to do that. So during the test match, I see them doing well because having gained that experience, playing against Germany, playing against Canada, and Hong Kong, you find they have gained a lot of experience, and so if that continues and we have good training program for the national team, we'll be able to overrun the other teams this time around. The under 20 team reached the finals of last year, the CAR. So probably now they are hitting to win the trophy, and more so they have a lot of support here at home. The test match is coming up. Yes. I hope Kenyan will be able to do well, depending with the teams they'll be able to invite, and that one will also make us to improve on the ranking of the 25 across the world. We had come to 22, and I know if the year goes well, probably with the chairman coming in, the guy who is much informed, we can make it top 20, and then we'll be able to get grants from the World Rugby.
As we finish, our next tour will be the Asian tour. We'll be playing Hong Kong and then Singapore.
Yeah.
Our senior players are back. They are training hard and they have to fuse with the young players.
Sure.
What are our chances? Are we going back to our usual position in the top 10?
Yeah, probably Hong Kong might be a bit difficult because of that particular group. Mm-hmm. But with good training, the coaches have known, the players are gelling up. Mm-hmm. Probably we'd be able to learn from that particular mistake that will be created in Hong Kong. But in Singapore, that's our hunting ground. We won in 2017.
Yes.
The players might want to bring the glory back. So I see Singapore will do well. And we'll be able to, probably we'll be, definitely we'll be among the top 10 in Singapore.
Well, thank you, Mwalimu, for coming here on the Touchline. Now, it is a very big weekend for Mwalimu here, plus the board. They are going to come up and do something for Kenya Rugby because this is their time, and we hope them and we wish them success as they are going on. As we told you earlier, it is going to be a big night here in Nairobi. It's Nairobi Fight Night, and Fatuma Zarika will be flying the Kenyan flag. When we come back, we'll be doing a sneak preview of what will be happening tonight in boxing. But before that, let's listen in and watch Judy Waguthi, one of our boxing heroes here in Kenya.
What happened to your homeboy, Queen?